All right, in the next couple questions, they're going to ask you to find an equation for the line below. So now, instead of graphing an equation, graphing a line based on a given equation, you're going to go reverse. So what I call this is, I call this build an equation. So if you think of Disneyland, where they say they have a Build-A-Bear. So when you do a Build-A-Bear, you get parts of the bears together and then you put it together. So building equations, similar idea. So I'm just gonna use the, there's two formulas to build an equation. You could use this one or the y minus y1 equals to m times x minus x1. But just for simplicity's sake, I'm just gonna teach one equation, which is just this, the slope-intercept form. So you wanna build this equation. So you need the slope and the y-intercept. So if I look at this, I ask myself, do I know what the y-intercept is? Well, it looks like it's 1 point something. It's not really exact. So I wouldn't use that as the y-intercept because I can't tell exactly where it is. So with Alex, it gives you kind of dots to say, hey, use these dots, right? So if I don't know what the y-intercept is, I'm gonna use another method. So here, if I have these two dots that are given by Alex, I'm gonna say, okay, this dot here, the address of this is 6, and this went up 3. The address of this is -4, +1, because it went to the left 4 and up 1. So once I have these two points, whenever you have two points, you can always find the slope. So you can find the slope with two points. So as long as you have two points, you can always find the slope. So the slope here, again, review, is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So difference between the y values. So here are the y values, the second part of the point. So I'm gonna do 3 minus 1. So if I do 3 minus 1, then I need to do the same order on the bottom. I'm gonna do 6 minus and -4. And I should expect that my slope is going to be positive since we're going uphill. So I'm expecting the slope is positive. So let's make sure our answer becomes positive. So in here, 3 minus 1 is 2. 6 minus and -4 is 6 plus 4, which is 10. The top and the bottom are divisible by 2. So divide both sides, both up and down, by 2. So I get 1/5. So the slope is 1/5, and yes, it is positive. And that confirms that this line is positive, it is going upwards. So the slope is positive. So when I write this problem, I'm gonna have y is equal to 1/5 x + b. So when I am building an equation, I just need to find out what m is and what b is. I leave the x and y as is. So now I need to find out what b is. So find b. Well, how in the world do you find out what b is, right? B looks like it's 1.9 or something, but we can't just guesstimate based on looking at it visually. We need to know what it is exactly. So the how you find out exactly what b is that you're gonna plug in either point as x and y. So you can use either point. So whichever point you use, you'll get the same answer. So I'm gonna use the 6 and 3. So it doesn't matter which one you use, you should get the same answer. So I'm gonna plug it into this equation here. So the y is a 3, and the x is a 6. So I'm gonna solve for b. So I get 3 is equal to, well, 1/5 times 6. The 6 is in the numerator, so I get 6/5 + b. To get b sitting by itself, I need to subtract 6/5 on both sides. So 3 minus 6/5. So again, you could do it by hand or you could just use your calculator. 3 minus (6/5). And I end up getting 1.8, but I want to write this as a fraction. So I'm gonna take, I'm gonna press second, and I'm gonna push fraction to decimal or decimal to fraction. And I'm gonna get 9/5. So here, b is 9/5. B is equal to 9/5. And if you don't have a calculator on hand, so I'm gonna replace this as 9/5. So this becomes my answer for the problem. 1/5 x + 9/5 is equal to y. This is building equation. And just letting you know, if you don't have a calculator, if you don't want to use one, 3 minus 6/5, I just want to show you how you get 9/5. You can write as a fraction as 3/1 minus 6/5. You need a lowest common denominator. Lowest common denominator is 5. Change it to 5. So if you change the 1 to 5, you also need to change the 3. You need to multiply that by 5, and that'll give you 15. So 15/5 minus 6/5, same denominator. Keep the denominator the same, so 15 minus 6 is 9, so 9/5. Okay, so your answer is 1/5 x plus 9/5 is equal to y.